Hi, folks. Ken Greene here. Pray you're having a good day today, all day long. Just wanted to bring you a thought today, another one of my music devotionals, I call them. And I just want to talk to you a little bit about redemption. You know, the Bible says in 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 18 and 19, and I'm just going to paraphrase, he says, "You're not redeemed by silver and gold, but with the precious blood of Christ as a lamb without spot." And so we find that we're redeemed through the blood of Jesus Christ. You say, well, what does that mean to me? You see, going all the way back to the very beginning, we find, you know, when God created this beautiful world, he put man in it to have fellowship with him. And of course, he gave him one negative, I call it a negative commandment, but really all the commandments of God are not really negative. They're meant to serve a purpose. God told him many things to do, to name the animals, to dress the garden. But he also told him to not eat of a tree, the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And so when Adam disobeyed that command, every unborn child in Adam died. And that's how that we inherited this thing called sin. That's the reason there's death in the earth. That's the reason there's chaos in the earth. It's not God's fault, but it's because of our great-great-granddaddy Adam. When Adam sinned, every unborn child died. But the Bible says that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. So God had a plan. Even the Bible says from the foundation of the world, he had a plan to redeem us back. And that redemption comes through the blood of Jesus. And of course, knowing that God is God, a progressive God, he gave us the law. You know, we have the Bible that's in two. The Bible says the Old Testament and the New Testament. That just simply means there's an old covenant and then there's a new covenant. And of course, the old covenant, God gave them the Ten Commandments. In fact, the law has 613 commands, and God knew that there was no way that they could keep them. Even in Exodus 20, when God gave the Ten Commandments, the very next thing he tells them what to do when they break the commandments, what sacrifices to offer. For he knew that they could not keep the commandments. Well, what was God doing? He was teaching us that we need more than ourselves. We need a Savior. We need someone to come in and to change our hearts. And that's what Jesus did when he came. He said, "You've heard it said of old in the Old Testament, thou shalt not kill. But I say, don't even hate without a cause." And so Jesus came to deal with the root problems. And that root problem is sin. And he went to the cross and died. And all who receive him, the Bible says, we become new creatures in Christ. Old things are passed away. All things become new. And so I'm just going to share a little song today. It's about, it's called "I Know That My Redeemer Lives." And most of my songs are ones that I have written, but this song is just so beautiful by Nicole Mullins. And listen to the words. Who taught the sun where to stand in the morning? And who taught the ocean you can only come this far? And who showed the moon where to hide until the evening? Whose words alone can catch a falling star? Well, I know my Redeemer lives. Yes, I know my Redeemer lives. All creation testify this life within me cries, and I know my Redeemer lives. The very same God that spins things in orbit runs to the weary, the worn, and the weak. And the same gentle hand that holds me when I'm broken. They conquer death to bring me victory. Well, I know my Redeemer lives. Yes, I know my Redeemer lives. All creation testifies, and this light within me cries, I know my Redeemer, He lives to take away my shame. He lives now forever proclaim that the life, oh, He gave was a gift for my sin. But now He's alive and there's an empty grave. And I know my Redeemer lives. Yes, I know my Redeemer lives. All creation testifies, and this light within me cries, yes, I know my Redeemer lives. Well, I hope you enjoyed that song, and think about what Jesus has done for you. God bless you. Thank you for joining me today.